वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक फोर्थ सेम सब्जेक्ट डाटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स। माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। सो टूडेज टॉपिक इज मल्टी कास्ट राउटिंग एंड एनी कास्ट राउटिंग। सो ओके हियर, सो सम एप्लीकेशन सच एज मल्टीप्लेयर गेम और लाइव वीडियोज ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स इवेंट स्ट्रीम्ड टू मेनी व्यूइंग लोकेशंस, सेंड पैकेज टू मल्टीपल रिसीवर्स एंड अनलेस द ग्रुप इज वेरी स्मॉल, सेंडिंग ए डिस्टिंक्ट पैकेट टू ईच रिसीवर इज एक्सपेंसिव। एंड ऑन अदर हैंड, ब्रॉडकास्टिंग ए पैकेट इज वेस्टफुल इफ द ग्रुप कंसिस्ट ऑफ से 1000 मशीन्स ऑन ए मिलियन नोड नेटवर्क, सो दैट मोस्ट रिसीवर्स आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन द मैसेज and thus we need a way to send messages to well defined groups that are numerically large in size but small compared to the network as a whole. And sending a message such a group is called multicasting, and the routing algorithms used is called multicast routing. So all multicasting schemes require some way to create and destroy groups and to identify which routers are members of a group, and how this task are accomplished is not of a concern to the routing algorithm. But we will assume that each group is identified by a multicast address and that routers know the group to which they belong. So multicast routing scheme built on the broadcast routing scheme, and we have already studied just sending packets along spanning tree to deliver the packet to the members of the group while making efficient use of bandwidth. So the best spanning tree to use depends on whether the group is dense and with receivers scattered over most of the network, or sparse with much of the network not belonging to the group. So if the group is dense, broadcast is a good start because it efficiently gets the packet to all parts of the network, but broadcast will reach some routers that are not members of the group and which is wasteful. And so the solution explored by Deering and Cheriton's 1990 is to prune the broadcast spanning tree by removing links that do not lead to members, and the result is an efficient multicast spanning tree. So here an example, there are two groups 1 and 2 in the networks, so in figure A and a network figure A. So some routers are attached to host that belong to one or both of the these groups as indicated in the figure, and a spanning tree for the leftmost router is shown in figure B. So this tree can be used for broadcast but is overkill for multicast, as can be seen from the two pruned versions that are shown next. So in C, figure C, all the links that do not lead to hosts that are members of group and have been removed, and the result is the multicast spanning tree for the leftmost router to send a group 1. So here one group have members of group 1 have been removed, so the result in the multicasting spanning tree for the leftmost router to send to group 1, and packets are forwarded only along the spanning tree, which is more efficient than the broadcast tree because there are 7 links instead of 10. So in figure D shows the multicast spanning tree after pruning for group 2, and it is efficient to with only 5 links this time. It also shows that different multicast group have different spanning trees, and various way of pruning the spanning tree are possible. The simplest one can be used if link state routing is used and each router is aware of the complete topology, including which host belongs to which group, and each router can then construct its own pruned spanning tree for each sender to the group in question by constructing a sync tree for the sender as usual, and then removing all links that do not connect group member to the sync node. So MOSPF, multicast OSPF, is an example of a link state protocol that works in this way. Okay, and with distance vector routing, a different pruning strategy can be followed. The basic algorithm is reverse path forwarding, and whenever a router with no host interested in a particular group and no connections to other routers receives a multicast message for that group, it responds with a prune message and telling the neighbor that sends the message not to send it anymore multicast from the sender for that group. When a router with no group members among its own host has received such messages on all the lines to which it sends the multicast and multicast it to, and can respond with a prune message. And in this way, the spanning tree is recursively pruned, and DVMRP, distance vector multicast routing protocol, is an example of a multicast routing protocol that works this way. Then pruning results in efficient spanning tree that use only the links that are actually needed to reach members of the group. One potential disadvantage is that it is lots of work for routers, especially for large networks. And suppose that a network has n group, each with an average of m nodes, and each router for each group. So m pruned spanning tree with tree must be stored for a total of m entries. So here is example figure C, here in 5.16. Figure C gives the spanning tree for the leftmost router to send the group 1, and the spanning tree for the rightmost router to send to group 1. And it will look quite different, as packets will head directly for a group members rather than via the left side of the graph. And this is in turn means that routers must forward packets destined to group 1 in different directions depending on which node is sending to the group. When many large groups with many senders exist, considerable storage is needed to store all the trees. And an alternative design uses core based trees to compute a single spanning tree for the group, and all of the routers agree on a route called the core or rendezvous point and build the tree by sending a packet from each member to the route. This is the union of the paths traced by this packet. So here in figure 5.17a shows a core based tree for group 1, and to send to this group, a sender sends a packet to the core. When the packet reaches the core, it is forwarded down to the tree, and in figure B, for the sender on the right hand side of the network. So as a performance optimization, packet destined for the group do not need to reach the core before they are multicast, and as soon as packet reaches the tree, it can be forwarded up towards the root as well as down all the other branches. This is the case for the sender at the top, you can see in figure B. So having a shared tree is not optimal for all sources, and for example in figure 5.17b, the packets from the sender on the right hand side reaches the top right group member via the core in three hops instead of directly, and the inefficiency depends on where the core and senders are located. But often it is reasonable when the core is in the middle of the senders. When there is only a single sender, as in a video that is streamed to a group using the sender as the core, is optimal. And also there is a note that is that shared tree can be major savings in storage cost, message sent and computation. Each router have has to keep only one tree per group instead of m trees, and further routers routers that are not part of the tree do not work at it at all to support the group. And for this reason, shared tree approaches like core based trees are used for multicasting to sparse group in the internet as part of popular protocols such as PIM, protocol independent multicast. So that's all about multicast. So next topic is anycast routing. We will discuss little bit about anycast routing. Delivery models such in which a source sends to a single destination called unicast, as we know, and to all destinations called broadcast, and to a group of destinations called multicast. So another delivery model called anycast is sometimes also useful. In anycast, a packet is delivered to the nearest member of the group and scheme that finds this path are called anycast routing. So there are a question, why would we want anycast? So sometimes nodes provide a service such as time of day or a contents distribution for which it is getting the right information, all that matters, and not the node that is contacted, and any node will do. So for example, anycast is used in the internet as part of BNS, and we will not have to devise new routing scheme for anycast, because regular distance vector and link state routing can produce anycast routes. And suppose we want to anycast to the members of group 1, they will all be given the address 1 instead of different addresses. So distance vector routing will distribute vectors as usual, and nodes will choose the shortest path to destination 1, and this will result in nodes sending to the nearest instance of destination 1. So the routes are shown in figure here A, and this procedure works because the routing protocol does not realize that there are multiple instances of destination 1, and that is, it believes that all the instances of node 1 are the same node, as shown in topology here, figure B. And this procedure works for link state routing as well, and although there is the added consideration that the routing protocol must not find seemingly short paths that pass through node 1, and this would result in jumps through hyperspace. And since the instance of node 1 are really nodes located in different parts of the network, and link state protocols already make this distinctions between routers and host. So that's all about anycast. So here session ends here, and thank you.